Hello you guys, today we talk about how to replacing main jet.
If the main jet inside has become oval and worn out, then it is better to change it to a new one. This method, which we'll use today, is only suitable for adjustable needle carburetors. First, we need to disassemble the carburetor. Unscrew the top screws with a Phillips screwdriver. I must say right away that if your carburetor is regulated using the main jet, then you will need a special tool for installation. If this is so, then you will need a special tools, and this is already a royal pain in the rear. So, today we're repairing a carburetor with top adjustment. If you are sure that your carburetor is an adjustable needle, then we can tune it. And now we unscrew the screws of the floor chamber. And the screws are different lengths. Also, be prepared to need a new floor chamber gasket. If they open the floor chamber, then we need to see if everything inside is in good condition. I'm talking about the condition of all the important components that are in the floor chamber. If we open the floor chamber, then we need to be very careful with all parts. The float must be removed very carefully because its holder cannot be replaced. Okay, we disassembled the carburetor enough to replace the main jet. So let's make sure once again that it is really worn out from the inside. It is very important because the replacement procedure is not easy. If we are 100% sure, then let's start. Of course, we can check the jet with caliper. Once again, I repeat that this data is only for a carburetor with an adjustable needle. If the carburetor is with a non-adjustable needle, its adjustment is made by adjusting the main jet. For pressing out and pressing in the main jet, you need to find these special tubes. Prepare our place to work. At the time of work, I install the floor chamber back again. We'll press out the main jet from the side of the piston toward the floor chamber. Our special tubing must be of the correct diameter. Put the tube in the correct position and start humming to it. We need to make sure we're going in the right way. I think that everything is good, the jet is not frozen and comes out well. We're in the right way and therefore we'll continue. Let's check again if everything is okay. So, guys, we pulled out the main jet. Let's take a look at these two jets. This carburetor uses main jet with size 1/10 inch inside diameter of jet. Let's see how oval our old jet. I'm using jet from this carburetor kit. This jet really oval and need replacing. Now we turn our carburetor upside down. And we come to the most interesting moment of the pressing main jet. I like just oil with Tiger, but you can use any other oil. I use a little oil to make the jet press better. I just need one drop of oil. Now we can coat the jet in oil so that it is better pressed. I think that the oil is enough and nothing needs to be heated. Now we'll press it into the carburetor body. I remove the carburetor floor chamber cover again. Now we must correctly install the jet. We need to be very careful because it will be difficult to remake something. We need to spend a certain amount of time to properly direct the jet. If we do something wrong now, then all the work will be spoiled. Take a look at the jet. See how it installed. Now we need a special tube that fits exactly in diameter. Always press the jet from the side of the floor chamber. Now we take our big hammer and check from time to time how far we've gone. It is better to check now very often than to remaking later. Don't be lazy and check again. It looks like it's done. Just little bit again and everything will be ready. Well, we pressed the main jet and now we just need to fit in place all the parts that we removed. In any way, the floor chamber gasket must always be installed, only new one. One gasket is not sold separately, so you may need to buy a full set of gaskets. How nice to see our work we did today. Keep in mind that after replacing the jet, it is necessary to adjust the carburetor. I'll say again that if your carburetor doesn't have an adjustable needle, then you will need a special tool to replace and adjust the main jet. But you can just bypass this royal pain in the rear if you install adjustable main jet. You should also always monitoring the condition of the rubber rings. I really like the bottom adjustable carburetor. Here is a list of carburetor parts that were installed on Volvo 240 series with B21A engine. Thanks for watching. Bye for now.